Tosari from the University of Tampere. You're working with smart traffic business development, and you've also worked 20 plus years in different positions at Nokia. You're one of the main driving forces behind mobility as a service in Finland. So please welcome Jukka Lintusaari.
I feel a little bit deja vu feelings at the moment. So after working in telecom industry pretty long time, that about 20 years ago, there was similar conferences in the telecom cluster, and then people were claiming that now you, Nokia and Ericsson, others, you made the biggest mistake you can ever do, focusing for such tiny business what is mobile industry. There are not more than 2% of the people who even need a mobile phone. It costs half a year's salary. So now you make the big mistake. And we all know then what finally happened with the whole element, what was ongoing, that how big this area is at the moment. Mars is something similar. People claim that when Henry Ford, long time ago, did ask from end users that what you want to have new things. And all people were telling for him that please invest more to hormones because we need faster horses. And he was then a clever innovator and decided to design a new car instead of investing to hormones. And once again, he made a big change in the whole ecosystem. The last 100 years has been around the car and around its usage. At the moment, there's about 1.2 billion cars. And if everything goes as forecasted, soon there should be about 3 billion cars, which we all know is totally impossible. So I believe that when we start to have better understanding of the mass, how things proceed, that it's even maybe bigger change in the society than what was Henry Ford as a tough innovator making the first T4 to the marketplace. So that's why I'm not a typical researcher in the university. I'm mostly working with the real researchers to help them to guide business-driven focus for their working practices. There are multiple different research teams who start to understand what does it mean for city planning and user experience and so on. And also what I focus now more about the Finnish status at the moment, that how the data is needed. Normally when we talk about this mass, and then always most of people speak about multimodal transportation. So this is the important element what is needed. But I believe that we normally forget this, that what is finally also needed, that is open innovation. I visited ITS World Congresses now multiple years, and most of the things have to say, sorry to say that, there are experts talking to experts, authorities talking to authorities, and not a single end user around. Not a single end user. Last year, the European World Congress was in Helsinki, and we organized maybe first ever end user focus, ITS in your pocket. We gave public transport data for students, for about 90 students around Europe in different universities, and have to say that there were clever ideas. We create here engineers, we could even never think how to use this public transportation data with totally new innovations. So we need new innovations, and we always know now that because other new startups and what has been created, the business model is still unclear. We don't know yet where the money flows into the mass ecosystem. We know that it's there somewhere, but this has not yet been created, and most probably when the end users start to understand, the need starts to grow to make this happen. And access to data is one of the key elements, especially in this area. How to make this multimodal city data available? We need to know the 3D models of the cities that the autonomous cars could go around in this area. And this is something where cities are not maybe so good, especially when I travel now around Europe. When you start to talk about open data, the first definition is that what does the data mean, what is the open data, how to use this happen. This is something we have to practice a lot. Because finally we need also those new sources from the cities, how the cities start to open the data in good ways. Data mining and integration is something what is the easier part, once again technical part, what we engineers will solve the areas. And also as in the presentation about the Gothenburg city, the whole sharing economy and replanning the city is in front of us. There are calculations that if I can pre-book my parking lot in advance, especially in big cities, about 1/3 of the downtown traffic will disappear. So instead of making the society alive, building new bridges, maybe we should take away one bridge and then start to look at how do I pre-book this, and we can start to total new innovations in this way. The other one before the industry start to be interested about this is the scalability. At the moment, most of the solutions are created per city, per two cities, but the scalability, how you go through different cities and different countries, is the only way how we can attract new companies to work with this case. And also the timing. As telecom industry growth, it has taken 20 years, it's still growing a lot. We have to find also different milestones, when happening and what. And the first step, what is at the moment in our focus, is this, that cars start to be digital. In Stuttgart alone, they count that they are missing about 40,000 ICT experts. Cars start to be totally digital, cars start to have a lot of sensors which could be used. The first phase of Mars could be around the digital car sensors, how those could be created. And this business is on at the moment. There are a huge amount of innovation what local car manufacturers here in different countries. In China, there are about 100 car manufacturers at the moment looking how the car as such could be stronger in the area. But this is still a silo on the road. Having most of the sensors around Google, autonomous cars goes around just with the sensors. The next step is that when the infrastructure starts to be around, you can start to connect the digital data what is coming to the city. You can start to know in advance, about 3 blocks earlier, that now this crossing is blocked or the traffic light is now red, so I start to fine tune this. And then you start to have new phases of Mars. Then most probably, for some logistics, will be one of the first elements which will be created with the Mars elements. And then multimodal traffic data could be much easier to be integrated to the car, so car will be integrated. Big companies are looking at the moment how you integrate the whole city data. That if in this part of the city is raining, it's Thursday evening, here's an ice hockey between Finland and Sweden, and then you start to calculate that now within 2 hours there will be a traffic jam in this part of the city, how I can start to find the traffic lights, and even then that because it starts to be frozen, then I have to call a few doctors, most of the hospitals, the people will fall down and they break their bones. This is the area of what is coming to the final one, and it takes 10-15 years, the first elements. If we are not able to create phases and roadmap how to go further, we are messy. We don't know where to focus and how to go further. That's why what we are working at the moment is this, that we work how to collect data in a good way. I found this statement, I don't know if this, at least I found it from the internet, that in a country we trust and everybody else should bring data. And this is something what we are now working at the moment, that we collected different data sources. We established wiki pages for people, for startups and companies to use the data. Like the public transportation in Tampere, all the buses have a GPS, so we can provide the data where the bus should be, what is the timetable, where the bus really is based on the GPS, or we collect the data from the traffic lights, that about 60 parameters are available from traffic lights every second, how to fine-tune it. This is not easy. I have to say that the collecting the data in proper way is a lot of work, and in Finland at the moment for the big six biggest cities are at the moment looking how they collect the data in a good way together. This is maybe the biggest ever problem. How to be provide the service level agreement. When you're on top of data, you have the custom interface. How to make this happen? And this is area, once again, what we should do a lot. This is the picture how the Finnish ministry is guiding us. There's going to be new phases or new type of transportation models. We have now about 6-7 mass operators who claim that they start to be mass operator in pipeline at the moment, how they start to develop their services, and the first launches will be in January-February time frame in Finland. Tekes, the local of Innova partner, has been very active helping them to get started. And we look mostly the technical part, how this could be happen. Finnish ministry is working at the moment with the harmonization deregulation actively. The work has started now that during this year, and then there will be 3 different phases how the transport should be deregulated totally. This is, without this, this won't happen. But then one of the elements we are talking about also about the international part of this. This Mars Alliance was launched in October in Bordeaux. If this will be well set up and well organized, this is one of the tools how to make this international. So 2016 will be the year that we see if this is one of the elements, like CSM Association, like 3GPP or any forums where they are doing the internal collaboration, how this will happen. Without a formalized way of working together globally, nothing will scale up. This was
Thank you. And now we have next speaker is Martin Böhm from Austria Tech. Welcome. You are head of business unit mobility systems and IT.